testimony, you can say anything, you can just raise your right hand. Do you swear that the testimony that you're about to give will be the truth, and the truth, and the whole truth under the pains and penalties of perjury?
I do.
Okay, you can have a seat, make yourself comfortable.
And there's a microphone right in front of you. Just make sure that you're talking into that. Can you start by stating and spelling your full name for the record?
Katie, K-A-T-I-E, Morin, M-O-R-I-N.
And what's your date of birth, Ms. Morin?
6/10/78.
What city and state do you currently reside in?
Laconia, New Hampshire.
And how long have you lived in Laconia?
About 3 years.
How are you presently employed?
I work in retail.
In retail? And how long have you done that? How long have you worked in retail?
My whole life, about 20 years, probably.
And what's your highest level of education, Ms. Morin?
GED.
Do you know someone named Adam Montgomery?
Yes, I do.
And can you tell these jurors how you know Adam Montgomery?
We were in a rehab facility together, and then we became romantically involved for a little bit.
What year would that have been in that you were romantically involved with the defendant, Adam Montgomery?
2021.
And, Your Honor, may I?
Yes.
And Your Honor, I'm showing the witness what's been published as State's Exhibit 101. Ms. Morin, do you recognize?
Yes, I do.
The individual that's there?
Yes, I do.
And who is that individual?
It's Adam Montgomery.
That was the individual that you were romantically involved with in 2021?
Yes.
Were you aware of whether or not the defendant was married at that time?
I was.
And did he tell you, did he ever tell you anything about his wife?
Not just that they hadn't seen each other in a while.
Do you remember providing a statement to an officer with the Manchester Police Department back in February of 2022?
I do.
And that statement was regarding the defendant, is that right?
It was.
Do you think that seeing that statement would refresh your recollection of what the defendant may have said to you about his spouse, about his wife?
No, I recall.
Okay. And what do you recall him saying about his wife?
That she would do anything for him.
That she would do anything for him? During the time that you were romantically involved with the defendant, did he ever discuss his children?
He did.
So you were aware that he had children?
I was.
Was there a particular discussion with the defendant that stood out to you?
Yes.
About the children?
Yeah. And
tell us about that.
We were at lunch one day and just talking about our children in general, and he stated that the worst thing that he had ever, that had ever happened or he had done was he walked out of the bathroom and Harmony was suffocating the baby. So he backhanded her I don't know if it was as a reaction as the way it was told to me, to stop her from suffocating.
So he said he backhanded her.
Yes.
Did he say what the result of that backhand was?
He said he hit her glasses, so she ended up with a black eye.
Did he describe anything about that black eye that you just mentioned?
No.
In that conversation where he discussed causing that black eye, did he say that he had nudged Harmony out of the way?
I don't recall.
He said he backhanded her.
I don't recall his exact verbiage.
Did he ever discuss other children with you?
Yes.
And what were those discussions? What was the substance of those discussions?
He told me that he had five children, all under the age of seven. They all had the same mom. At one point, I asked him to go to Maine with me when I was leaving, and he said he would be too far away from his kids, so he could not.
If I could have just a moment.
Thank you, Ms. Morin. No additional questions.
No questions, Your Honor.
All right, you may step down.
Thank you.